Okay, I'm back. So the beer has been fermenting for, 11 days. So I'm going to be checking to see whether that's worked. And then I'm going to be adding the hops. Now, there's a little bit of a twist here. And to make it a little bit more agile, I'm going to be trying multiple parallel experiments. Well, when I say multiple, two. Because this is new to me and I want to learn as much as possible, as quickly as possible, I thought, well, rather than just following a recipe and getting 40 pints of one beer to see whether I like it or not, I thought, well, I'll split the base beer that I've brewed into two, and I'll use two different types of hops, and I can compare them. It'll be an A-B test, I suppose, what you could call that, and that will allow me to learn about two different types of hops simultaneously. Double my learning. So that's what I'm going to try and do. And it's gone down to one, which is kind of where I expected it to be. Probably not ready for drinking yet. Bring it up to the camera. There you go. See what this looks like. It smells like beer. It smells a bit nutty and fruity. It's actually pretty good. Yeah, it's got a little bit of bitterness to it. It's quite nice. Yeah, a little bit of fruit, a little bit of nuts. I can work with that. So the next step, because I'm making this more complicated for myself, is to get half of that mixture into another bucket, which will involve some siphoning. So this goes in here, and this. All right then, here goes. And it's going. Off it goes. Come back in a minute. I find siphoning amazing. I shouldn't really, it's quite simple, isn't it? But I just think it's ridiculously clever. So there is A. And here is B in my A-B test. Next up, the hops. Right, hops. So barrel A is going to be by the book. And that is English pale ale hop pellets. Nothing particularly special. There's 60 grams in here, so I'm going to weigh out 30 grams of those. Smell like beer. So they are going to go in bucket A. Lovely. Now the next bag is where the experiment begins. So I picked some Syrian Goldings hops from the shop. Just pretty much random, and we'll see what they're like. Now these look interesting. Look at that. I have no idea what that is. So, there, 30 grams. Oh, wow, that does smell good. Right, breaking them up and just sort of putting them in, really. I don't really know if there's much of a science to this. I'm sure there is. They seem to be floating. But that's not all. We need some more sugar. Okay, so 50 grams into bucket A, 50 grams into bucket B. I have to admit, I didn't think a beer spoon would be something that I would ever own, but welcome to the family. So bucket B, Syrian Goldings. Stir this one around. Here. And we're good to go. So we leave those to hop about for the next few days, and then we'll have the magical tasting. Now, I'm going to have to really try hard to resist tasting them myself. My plan is to take them to see Paul in a week or so's time when we next get together and taste them together. So the next step will be getting them from the buckets into the barrels, and then the barrels into a couple of bottles that I can transport to see Paul. So until next time.